Support for the vice chancellor. So that time and now, he has never looked back. We were still doing the analog student finish exam, go key on the doors of your lecturers and begin to look for your answers, your results. But now, Chief, from point of registration to payment of your fees to checking of your results, your parents can do that on their smartphones because the vice chancellor had a postgraduate degree in computer science, a mathematician, and he's all of that. And he does that in 6 months. We're collaborating with NAB and IFE.
Development. So, well, a registrar, I'm a learned colleague. But the boss of the industry, Tore Taiwo, some of the Nigerians here yet, and the Johnson. I want to sincerely mention something to Sam that our father, our brother, our mentor in the state. I think he will help us particularly appreciate. It's a wonderful woman. It's just today now, and congratulations to one of the other from NUC. Even though it's not from Ekiti, but today I think it's from Ekiti. So we just appreciate that. We just appreciate that so much. You're welcome. Welcome. Let me say that we thank you very much. One of our very good friends, we appreciate. So we are particular, and all other very important people here in this room. I want to say that we are particularly joyous to have you there. We are lucky, we are happy. We did it thinking that it would not work out, but the speed at which you accepted and the speed at which you work with us actually encouraged us. I've seen the big thing, and I didn't reach it to them, I just saw when we get there, they know the great thing that come to do for us. But please permit me, I'm not going to take that time, to say something about our university at the character. To treat us so well. Coincidentally, this one year was Makosa, that university. And then the registrar of the time is left us, Mr. Nyeri. And we treated so wonderfully. We were giving one aspect of the college. And within 6 months, we transformed that place. There were poor UCKD. I'm happy to say that two institutions cannot be located on the same contiguo. Happy that you're here, and it's like a dream. After the lecture, sir, like I said, I'm not even going to take around to see some of the things that are on our campus. Thank you very much, sir, for coming.
Okay. And at the same time, I would say that I'm privileged to be in your midst. I think the last time I was here was when I was a member of the council of this university, and that the vice chancellor. Well, I think Professor Yubodi was busy then. He used to come for council meetings here. And I think this building or the other one was housing the university council. And means, I see a lot of giants, tribes that have gone into this place. And thank God that I am a witness. I want to appreciate you, Mr. Westminster. It's part of the things what we have to discuss today. What is the problem with our country? And I always appreciate this quote from the history. The fault says it's not in our stars, but in ourselves. Leadership. That's what we are demonstrating. The type of leadership the nation needs, the type of leadership it needs, the type of leadership this university needs. Within a period of 3 years, you can see your fingers. Everywhere, touching everywhere, right from the gate. So, the elegant gate, the decoration, the everything, neat. Very neat. And you see the type of structures that we are putting in place. Not just anything that goes, but quality and qualitative. I'm proud of you. You asked me to extend the appreciation to the NUC. Ma'am, we appreciate you. Again, it says something about my hometown, the university there was like Chibi Road, there was a country. Maybe somebody will write there was a university. But it will reincarnate, I want to believe. But then I didn't agree with the NUC then, because it's part of the problems we have in Nigeria. And please take this to them. NUC is doing a good job. But at the same time, when you have a lot of people exercising powers, you know, giving directives, which I believe as a lawyer should not have been given, let me put it that mindful. How dare I do say that two campuses or two institutions cannot be, you know, contiguous to one another? I don't know which law regulates it. But then, let's forget about that for now. It's very sad. And some of your people from here, who are also from my hometown, were part and parcel of it. I had a stand then that, look, to me, university is the very ultimate. It's a bus stop. It's a cemetery. That's all we yearn for it. And let us have the university. But then, even despite the fact that I want to convince myself that people in my town love me, but they wanted to use them against me. I addressed the crowd, and from here, some people are saying, ah, Chidi Adebo Alako University, local university. You see, I'm a man that I feel fulfilled in God. I feel fulfilled in Christ. You don't say that you have Allah is my boss, he's my mentor, I am his mentee, he's my oga, let me put it away. But then everybody has had, every one of us has his own ministry. The ministry of Paul is different from that of Peter.
Yes.
And vice versa. I have my own ministry and I thank God that I'm fulfilling my mission in life. That's the ultimate. You have self-satisfaction. And that situation in Christ, the Lord and Savior. So they were saying, no, local university, I just laugh. I say, God forgive them. But then, they are forging ahead. This is the last counselor. I want to appreciate you. Now, before I'm done, you sent me a summons. It's there in the preamble of my lecture. Funny. About when? Obanpe oni odoba wa lona ise oba ose po odoba ose ose da koja. Now I am yours. Whatever woman is, whatever woman is, who is the best? And again, I want to give this example. When Peter was performing the first miracle, otherwise there wouldn't have been the church which you and me belong to, the crippled man was looking at him, dimming the flashlight of the apostles of Christ, Peter, John, and whatever. He wanted something from them. Then Peter said, silver or gold I have not. What I have I give unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ. He didn't stop at Jesus Christ. We're talking of nativity. He said, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I mean, it's not your version. I'm an African, I don't know whether it's not your version. He said, in the name, I don't know, Pastor. He said, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Perhaps he really put the word Nazareth.
Yes, sir.
That miracle would have become void. But deliberately, the Holy Spirit ministered to him. Take Christ to his nativity. What am I saying? Just oppose that with what we are saying. I am from here.
Yes, sir.
And when you ask me to come, let my charity begin at all. Salvation's love for them.
Hail, hail, Ekiti State University. Exu, exu, exu.
Vision Lecture is one of the events marking the activities of this year's convocation ceremony. Last year, we only had our 21st convocation lecture titled University Administration, the Role of Stakeholders. It was delivered by an eminent Nigerian and a legal icon, R.S. Afeba, that lies here. This year again, we are looking to attract another eminent Nigerian and a celebrated legal practitioner who is going to deliver this year's 22nd convocation lecture. The lecture is titled Breaking Egypt, the Cyclical Nature of Nigeria's Problems. You will all agree with me that given the present socio-economic and political situation in our country now, the topic of this year's convocation lecture is most appropriate, timely, and compelling. At the same time, our convocation lecturer too is eminently qualified for this lecture, because apart from his robust legal practice, he has seen it all. When you talk about legal practice in Nigeria, if not the foremost, is one of the foremost legal practitioners in Nigeria. And she was a Nigerian because if you look at the kind of events, today you see she representing President Jonathan. The next day is in the Supreme Court, representing Akintu Abubakar. They are on different political divides. That is to show you that she is a bit of an island and not political legal practitioner. We have some SAAs whose practices are largely dependent on political patronage. Chief is not cut out for that. I won't want to talk much because I want to allow my Vice Chancellor to present today's convocation lecture. Vice Chancellor, sir.
To present one of our own to the University Committee and today's very august occasion. I was privileged that this is the person I want to introduce and present to this gathering. Was in my office this morning. I sat by his side very, very happily because I've been seeing him from a very far distance. More importantly, on television. I'm happy to present Chief Bolela Ekpemu, SAN. Intelligent, industrious, indefatigable, innovative, informed, and this one has required an indigenous son of the state. Please join me to welcome the Chief Bolela Ekpemu.
Thank you. Therefore, parents found it relatively easy to point their words in a desired path. At that time, I'm talking about Nigerian colonial era, both walking, recreating, and eating dinner with the Yorubos. Those were, and it all took a head at Aboye Grammar School in Kere Ekiti before Ileja Grammar School and of course the University of Lagos. The common thread that connects his development through these institutions was that of advocacy. He would have a voice, very heavy. He found that he had a voice. He would speak to the heard and he would serve. A senior prefect at Aboye Grammar School, a secretary general of the University of Lagos Student Union, and an executive member of the National Union of Nigerian Students. Certainly, all of this provided the common impetus of agitation, of defense, of advocacy, of struggle, and of service. Called to power in July 1976, made notary public in 1987, and proclaimed senior advocate of Nigeria in July 1991. Chief Wale Olanibeko, breathed in the culture of advocacy, would become indeed a luminary, lighting the path of social justice and equity, championing the rule of law, and forcing its supremacy, even against the old culture of insisting that everybody and everyone has the right. There is something always triumphant about Chief Wale Olanibeko. He was Attorney General and Commissioner of Justice in the whole of the state. He became the 20th President of Nigerian Bar Association in 2002. And his tenure saw the association become a juristic person, suing and being sued. He is one of the four registered trustees of the Nigerian Bar Association. His formidable influence on this platform led him being called upon on three occasions to mediate and reconcile conflicts in different states of Nigeria. He pioneered the formation of West African Bar Association in 2004. I was a member of the GIGO committee set up by the Chief Justice of Nigeria in 2011. Free of care, what do you know? So, rather than pay, he was giving two scholarships to indigent and exceptional students. Now, his generosity was not listed on the tablet of the Ten Commandments. Perhaps it is because it is so contagious that no one, not even institutions, are free from it. Since, after all, we are run by human beings with interests, with desires, and with motives. Jealousy is never the monopoly of women, even though they are easy victims. Men too are jealous sometimes. Institutions are also jealous. A corner room in the heavenly mansion with men rule. Chief Wale Olanibeko mediated the deals with the government again in the most dimensional crisis of the last day at Bitola University of Okocha in Oyo State. Beyond the issue of identity crisis, the political mind remained so tense that a precise and insightful mind like that of Chief Wale Olanibeko was required to walk through the maze of interest and render equity to bitter all without sacrificing fairness.
A university that was locked up for 8 months is now thankfully flourishing under the symbiotic atmosphere that is sustained by collective responsibility. BCRCE's Chief Wole Oladipo continues to write, he continues to publish, and he continues to give lectures in law, politics, economics, education, and religion. His book, The Voice of Law and Social Change, published in 2 volumes, remains a reference text to jurists and the general public. The Wole Oladipo Scholarship Scheme continues to serve indigenous students in their hundreds. Some of the beneficiaries are now doctors, lawyers, engineers, pharmacists, educators. No philosophers yet, no historians yet, no zoologists yet.
Before attended several of the Oxford University. And according to Oxford, convocation has always been the chief legislative assembly of the university, called originally, and consisted of the leaders and all the leaders of the various faculties, some of them presided over by the chancellor. Mr. Chancellor, you are here. You are presiding. It was the chief card from being within the university from the sphere of which I've been with the name, only to the king. And what we believe that today we'll be able to take some decisions. Politics are made, decisions are taken, society castes are shattered. I want to believe also, and I want to be persuaded that through this lecture we might be able to shatter castes, society castes for our day and country in Nigeria. Herein lies the objectives of my address to you today. What do I want to achieve? I want to strive to ultimately promote the making of policies. Instead of the taking of well-thought and pragmatic decisions for national, state and institutional importance, and to inspire the charity of the cause, which will transmit and beyond country from the present basis, to the long-term plan of sustainable growth and development we all know it can achieve. Now, a university to me is a field of arena. And I want to borrow what a colleague of us said, and I'm putting it. The question of the state has been more than a resource to or a degree about the institution. It must be a community that is capable of producing quality leaders in platform for social and economic change and for the record with. I remember coming out of the university. We had the likes of Professor Abudabi, Ola, Udibode, to my mind, and a little of freedom. Man comes to the academics and place a shoulder, year in, year out. But those who are the leaders of tomorrow are not bred and armed with the nature, psychological, physical, spiritual, and mental, to fall into the danger. And that's what I say we do all to be able to achieve year in, year. The listing, she forgot that our law was the Pro-Chancellor of the University of Ghana. I mean, President of Ghana, now about the Law of the University. And here, like every other university of all, should be a market place of ideas. May I commend your doctors on this issue? For not committing you to the end of the University of Ghana, by our blessing this competition level, but also give me the ability to keep the topic to my friends. Now to the topic. Do I carry my goal to new custom? What do I do? What do I say? Am I the best of education? I can see a lot of gurus in education, professors, sitting in the front, and there are the leaders all over. What am I going to tell you about education? Do I address the subject of law? And what maybe you might not comply some of the tactic phrases? What does France do? What does France do? What does France? What does France? Did not affect your issue? Posting at the commission of the president to compensating the constitution, all these right things was a panoramic view to our position as a uniquely heterogeneous issue. Then let us have a flashback. Historically, naturally, traditionally, ethnically, geographically, is Nigeria a nation? Let us see your area. Let us look at the Bible. How are nations born? They gather together. They said, what are you see? The one who used wars and who is the camp. The one who created war, they wanted to see it. They started making an eruption. They built the Babylon. And God said, let us. He was talking to God the Son and God the Holy Spirit. Let us dismount
Thank you.
Nigeria has a lot of power to control the border in front of us. I never said that this is a very important condition.
Thank you.
Lagos. Now, Osegu was happy. He is a good speech. I want to be a good friend of mine. He said, I miss that you will look for the chair, the speaker. The very high progress that six grants and demand 10%. That was definitely 15%. You see, the servants, all the servants who are here, 25% 19, 66. 60, 10% now. It's more than this 10%. It's a question of, please, you take me out. You go, look for my anything. As it was in the beginning, it's now. In this day, and never shall be. That is the idea of the thing. Then, for a look from Deborah, to not the issue, from Abdullah Pastor, and I want to be beating themselves over and over again.
President. No man, or woman, still in principle, but almost as much as leader.
on the CNN. That day, CNN, look at the way they put the sign up. Right now, they move on. No business. But they do it. He signed a certain order, not saying no. One time, several times, not that. Because he must not say no at all. And he says,
you don't know
that a government can exercise, we are the best. It's not about the members of all that. They were the most that the government was the most advanced country in the world, technologically. Absolutely, considering the technical sophisticated level, the first and second of the world, it gave them a name, including Britain, comes to any contract. The first memo that was brought to my attention as well was a memo of 740 million for the construction of the Ajibade Road. Dr. Gani, you are here. Let's try your name. God bless you. I think you told the president, Sir President, can you approve this for me? He said, well, yeah, God, I don't do nothing.
Thank you.
But in terms of just deep knowledge, is any member of the group that is
Yeah. Because I'm not giving another job, but that very eminent son, has actually educated our mind, talked about the price that we have to pay, which we are paying already. And it is the price of all these errors of the past, the price of bad governance, the price of tribalism, the price of corruption, as all those things have been clearly explained to us in this election. And no wonder there is poverty in the nation. And as we clearly explained in this particular lecture, which is heavily captured in the book that I'm holding, this pamphlet, that we have problem poverty of infrastructure as a nation, roads. This one stare on the face of all of us. And then the power, basic amenities, all those things that we clearly explained in this lecture. But we thank God because the lecture did not just end by at the power of this change, he talked about the prospects. And therefore, as a nation, let's keep prospect. Since my name is my own word now, sir, I don't know whether I'm right to say this or to modify this. Since the problem of Nigeria is a critical nation, I prescribe that the solution should be political in nation. Focusing majorly on leadership, as I've said, leadership enacting and invoking transparency, truthfulness, and like I have in this booklet, invoking true federalism. It is too great today to listen to this great lecture. And I want to say, as you have actually told us, that the rule of law is different from the rule of man. We have learned a lot from this lecture. That was why I want to say that the past made the problem, Nigeria. The present nurtures the problem. Will posterity name this problem? That is the particular change that have been broken in this lecture. Once again, thank you, sir, for this great deal of for us. It will be long for us to forget this lecture. And I want to say, on behalf of council and on behalf of management, I want to say thank you that come here to bless us today with this academic game. I want to say that we have this happen with Dr. Tucson. We are going to have it in all the faculties. We are going to set up the faculty maybe in our library. Our law students are here and our law students are here. We are going to give them major copies, many of the copies of this particular lecture. Thank you, sir.
I went to the grammar school. I don't admire that. I don't like that money. But he saw a position there, he did not go. Because about last week we celebrated our 50th anniversary of the session. We did not know this, the great son of Ekiti. In fact, the great African, Ekiti's Nigerian. Somebody was saying maybe he's one of the foremost lawyers in this country today. He's not one of the foremost, he's the foremost lawyer. The PDP we suffered his tender setback and because of our people that got. Immediately we left up that day, I thought to myself, well, we are going to Supreme Court and what are the reason to have a anybody agreed? Nobody, anybody who has said, can you pass it? I said, of course, I will transfer him to my report. I called him the night there. I said, I would like to see you tomorrow. Secretary, he was having a killer. About that. For that, I said, interacting now for more than 30 years. I see him as a role model, a mentor, a great example to my own generation coming after his own in the TL. One of the things he identified in this question, which I just want to say a little thing about, is the issue of true federalism, the structure of Nigeria. It's a matter that has concerned me personally for more than 2 decades, and we have been working on it. As I stand here, I have in my library the Constitution of the Republic of Oduduwa, which we worked on about 20 years ago. When we talked about the
those of our leaders here are men as farmers who are here before independence. They will recall that we had an independent constitution. And then the Republican Constitution 1963, Independent Constitution 1960. To me, that was at least something that was near to what we can call true federalism in practice. How each region to make so constitution for itself. So you have Western Nigerian Constitution, you have Eastern Nigerian Constitution, you have Northern Nigerian Constitution. And then you have the Constitution of the Federal Republic, all the normal documents. What obtained in London did not necessarily obtain it in the West. For example, Western Nigeria Act, we are different groups, different tribes, different people, different nationalities. The British brought us together. I don't know what they did, they negotiated on how we want to exist after. What kind of leaders are we going to have? And that's the most issue. There's also something that we want to get that agreement. It's not that we want to get that agreement. And we need to have to have us all that we need to tell them what we want. What is the advice of this constitution is all the intents and purposes of the military constitution. In the past, regions we made money and made for general government. Everything, principle of the regulation was about that. That was very bad. Western region, we grow more, so if we go beyond Western region, then we go to Western region. Go to federal government and take it. So, we need all the problems that are identified by the federal government, as far as I'm concerned, a lot of things can be solved, even if we resolve it back. Go back to the idea of true federalism. You have your true federal issue. The American example of Zaire is that states in America, the government don't have the same money. The government of New York was about $200,000. When Clinton was governor of Arkansas and was regulated at $6,000. You see this fact. They have their own constitutions. So, they don't have to do anything. Any of the states will develop. If a legislation of companies is based on states, a lot of the main avenues that each region from this country have been brought back and centralized. Not to very much, different how they are. Something that we don't have to do with local government. Auto driving license. We can have to do that. Something that should be done with that we don't have to do with local government. The share of companies in this country, the first company was based on the regions. So we thank you for the best, Mr. God Almighty will continue to bless you. God Almighty will continue to be with you. And this profession you have chosen, and we have said, we will never go on any excuse. Thank you very much.
On behalf of the entire investing community, the Lobby Council management, we want to appreciate you for your highly educative, inspiring, thought-provoking conversation lecture, and we want you to just accept this as a token for all of us. Thank you very much.
Ekiti State University. Exu, shining all space, I say shine. The goal is clear, to best the best place, to strength and build salvation. Hail, hail, Ekiti State University.
Thank you.